to go and sympathize with him and comfort him. When they saw him from a distance, they could hardly recognize him. They began to weep aloud, and they tore their robes and sprinkled dust on their heads. They then sat on the ground with him for 7 days and 7 nights. No one said a word to him because they saw how great his suffering was. After this, Job opened his mouth and cursed the day of his birth.
May the day of my birth perish, and the night it was said, a boy is born. Why is light given to those in misery, and life to the bitter of soul, to those who long for death that does not come, who search for it more than for hidden treasure?
Then Eliphaz the Temanite replied, someone ventures a word with you, will you be impatient? But who can keep from speaking? Consider now, who, being innocent, has ever perished? Where were the upright ever destroyed? As I have observed, those who plow evil and those who sow trouble reap it. Can a mortal be more righteous than God? Can a man be more pure than his maker? Yet man is born to trouble as surely as sparks fly upward. Blessed is the man whom God corrects, so do not despise the discipline of the Almighty.
The arrows of the Almighty are in me, my spirit strained in their poison. God's terrors are marshaled against me. Oh, that I might have my request, that God would grant what I hope for, that God would be willing to crush me, to let those his hand, to let loose his hand and cut me off. Then I would still have this consolation, my joy in unrelenting pain, that I had not denied the words of the Holy One. Do you mean to correct what I say and treat the words of a despairing man as wind? You would even cast lots for the fatherless and barter away your friend. Relent, do not be unjust. Reconsider, for my integrity is at stake. Is there any wickedness on my lips? Can my mouth not discern malice? My body is clothed with worms and scabs. My skin is broken and festering.
Then Bildad the Shuhite replied,
how long will you say such things? Your words are a blustering wind. Does God pervert justice? Does the Almighty pervert what is right? When your children sinned against him, he gave them over to the penalty of their sin. Surely God does not reject a blameless man or strengthen the hands of evildoers.
Indeed, I know that this is true. But how can a mortal be righteous before God? Though I were innocent, I could not answer him. I could only plead with my judge for mercy. Even if I summoned him and he responded, I do not believe he would give me a hearing. When a land falls into the hands of the wicked, he blindfolds its judges. If it is not he, then who is it? He is not a man like me that I might answer him, that we might confront each other in court.
Then Zophar the Naamathite replied,
are all these words to go unanswered? Is this talker to be vindicated? Oh, how I wish that God would speak, that he would open his lips against you. Know then that God exacts of you less than your guilt deserves. If you put away the sin that is in your hand and allow no evil to dwell in your tent, then you will lift up your face without shame. You will stand firm and without fear.
What you know, I also know. I am not inferior to you, but I desire to speak to the Almighty and to argue my case with God. You, however, smear me with lies. You are worthless physicians, all of you. If only you would be altogether silent, for you, that would be wisdom. Will you speak wickedly on God's behalf? Will you speak deceitfully for him? Will you show him partiality? Will you argue the case for God? Would it turn out well if he examined you? Can you deceive him as you might deceive men? Though he slay me, yet will I hope in him. I will surely defend my ways to his face.
Then Eliphaz the Temanite replied,
would a wise man answer with empty notions or fill him?
by the neck and crushed me. He has made me his target, his archers surround me. Without pity, he pierces my kidneys. Again and again, he bursts upon me. He rushes at me like a warrior. My face is red with weeping. Deep shadows frame my eyes. Yet my hands have been free of violence, and my prayer is pure. Even now, my witness is in heaven. My advocate is on high.
Then Bildad the Shuhite replied,
When will you end these speeches? Be sensible, and then we can talk. The lamb of the wicked is snuffed out. The flame of his fire stops burning. The vigor of his step is weakened. His own schemes throw him down. Surely such is the dwelling of an evil man. Such is the place of one who knows not God.
How long will you torment me and crush me with words? If it is true that I have gone astray, my error remains my concern alone. Know that God has wronged me and drawn his net around me. My breath is offensive to my wife. I'm loathsome to my own brothers. I know that my Redeemer lives, and that in the end he will stand upon the earth. And after my skin has been destroyed, yet in my flesh I will see God.
Then Zophar the Nemethite replied,
my troubled thoughts brought me to answer, because I'm greatly disturbed. I hear a rebuke that dishonors me, and my understanding inspires me to reply, surely you know how it has been from of old. Ever since man was placed on earth, that the mirth of the wicked is brief, and the joy of the godless lasts but a moment.
Bear with me while I speak, and after I have spoken, mock on. How often is the lamp of the wicked snuffed out? How often does calamity come upon them, the fate God allots in his anger? If it is said, God stores up a man's punishment for his sons, let him repay the man himself, so that he will know it.
Then Eliphaz the Temanite replied,
can a man be a benefit to God? Can even a wise man benefit him? What pleasure would it give the Almighty if you were righteous? What would he gain if your ways were blameless? Is it for your piety that he rebukes you and brings charges against you? Is not your wickedness great? Are not your sins endless? If you return to the Almighty, then you will be restored.
Even today, my complaint is bitter. His hand is heavy in spite of my groaning. If only I knew where to find him, if only I could go to his dwelling, I would state my case before him and fill my mouth with arguments. I would find out what he would answer me and consider what he would say. From the city, the dying groan, and the throat of the wounded cries for help. Yet God pays no attention to your prayer.
Then Bildad the Shuhite replied,
how then can a man be righteous before God? How can one born of woman be pure? If even the moon is not bright and the stars are not pure in his eyes, how much less man, who is but a maggot, a son of man, who is only a worm?
As surely as God